In 2019, the Walt Disney Company announced a massive investment in its recently acquired Disneyland Resort Paris property. Disney gobbled up shares and became the majority owner of Euro Disney SCA for the first time, having previously owned a large but minority stake. For theme park fans, it was about time. Often derided and more often than that at the bottom of most Disney park fans' lists, Disneyland Paris was desperately in need of investment, and it looked like Disney was about to deliver.
Madame, Monsieur, bonsoir, bienvenue dans ce journal. Voici les titres. Y a-t-il du relâchement dans l'air? Avec le beau temps, les Français se sont davantage déplacés ces derniers jours et particulièrement aujourd'hui. Mais ce n'est rien, vous le verrez.
However, all of this happened shortly before COVID-19 came along, and with the global pandemic firmly taking hold in France, Disneyland Paris was struggling to operate, let alone worry about expanding. Just when it looked like the future was bright for Disneyland Paris, COVID-19 has thrown investment in the resort into doubt. Then, Disney CEO Bob Iger and current CEO Bob Chapek met with French President Emmanuel Macron at the Élysée Palace with quite a splash of publicity, promising to invest over 2 billion euros into Disneyland Paris. In Disney's original agreement with the Republic of France, they were contractually obligated to construct a third theme park after Disneyland Park and the Walt Disney Studios Park. However, the company now has until 2035 until this is required. However, a 2 billion euro investment was welcome news for many, and for the first time in a while, fans could be genuinely excited about the future of Disneyland Paris. Disney swiftly announced that Mickey's PhilharMagic, a direct clone of the show in Fantasyland at the Magic Kingdom, would open in Discovery Theater, replacing Captain EO. Many were baffled, considering the location of the theater and the fact that the show was over a decade old at this point. However, it was the first new attraction for Disneyland Park since Buzz Lightyear made his way to Discoveryland in 2006, apart from Star Tours 2. Many fans welcomed this addition. Disney stated that Disney Village, the resort's answer to Disney Springs or Downtown Disney, would receive much-needed investment. Compared to its counterparts around the world, Disney Village is almost embarrassing. Haphazard, unwelcoming, and dated, the village could be the focal point of the resort if it wanted to be, and Disney were making the right noises in terms of agreeing with this sentiment. Almost no details were announced, but it looked like Disney Village was finally about to get the love it deserved. Still, Disney were not about to spend 2 billion euros on a row of shops and restaurants, so where was the bulk of the investment set to go? Walt Disney Studios Park opened at the Disneyland Resort Paris in March 2002, built hastily to try and turn around the fortunes of the struggling resort. Opening with 9 attractions, of which only 3 were rides, the park had the opposite effect, being derided by both critics and guests. The park dragged down the finances of Disneyland Paris, and its lack of attractions, theming, and overall Disney feel shot it down the list of global Disney parks. Piecemeal additions over the years led to even more of a chaotic feel, with the opening of the Hollywood Tower of Terror, as well as original attractions Crush's Coaster welcomed, but also criticized for fitting into the park poorly in terms of look and feel. In the early 2010s, the resort bet the house on a new addition to the studio's park, Ratatouille Remy's Totally Zany Adventure, or known in English as simply The Adventure, debuted in 2014 to critical success. The park had spent big on both the ride itself and the surrounding area, and the beautifully themed Ratatouille Miniland was a massive hit, complete with the Ratatouille The Adventure trackless dark ride attraction, as well as the Bistro Chez Remy table service restaurant. The land felt like an exciting indicator for the future of the park. When Disney announced its investment plans for the park, as well as revealing a tantalizing piece of concept art, it felt like the natural progression of the foundation built by Ratatouille. Disney announced that Walt Disney Studios Park would be expanded, with a large lake surrounded by lands dedicated to Star Wars and Frozen. The backlot section of the park would be rethemed and expanded into Marvel Avengers Campus, a companion to similar expansions at Disney California Adventure and Hong Kong Disneyland. Frozen is overwhelmingly popular, so seeing a land dedicated to it, similar to the planned expansion for Tokyo DisneySea, is not surprising. However, seeing the inclusion of a possible French version of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, Disney's budget-busting Star Wars Megaland felt like an overwhelming expression in confidence for the future of not just Walt Disney Studios Park, but the Disneyland Resort Paris as a whole. However, as 2020 came around, so too did COVID-19. Disney parks across the world were shuttered. Disney claimed its first annual loss in over 40 years, and nearly 30,000 cast members were laid off at the US parks. None of this makes for the kind of environment where mega expansions are encouraged as the corporate coffers close and cutbacks are made. So, where does that leave Walt Disney Studios Park? Really, this could go one of three different ways. Disney cuts its losses and cancels the expansion plans. Work is already underway for Avengers Campus, so this will stay, but the possibility of cutbacks here is very real. Disney could revive the plans in the future when economic winds are more favorable. Disney presses ahead with the plans on a much smaller scale. Star Wars likely goes out of the window, but Frozen could be built in a much smaller form, similar to the scale of Ratatouille. A small expansion to Toy Story Playland, which was on the concept art, would also be a possibility. Disney goes all out, and wanting to boost confidence in the resort, doubles down on its investment plans, carrying out its original expansion program, albeit with a delayed timescale. Nobody really knows which way Disney will go on this one, but here's hoping they don't cancel the plans. It would also be a shame to see a scaled-down version of the investment that this park truly needs. The park has relied on sticking plasters for far too long, and needs Disney California Adventure levels of investment to truly bring it up to par. Let's hope Disney agrees. Let us know what you think in the comments. For more theme park videos, news, and features, check out this channel or visit us at themeparkportal.com. See you next time, guys.